Hey, what's up Blender artists, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video we're going to talk about wet maps with Mantaflow. This video will be split into two parts, both being a bit shorter but in my eyes pretty relevant. I will first explain you the main principle of wet maps in Blender, and then show you how to iterate with this knowledge and create other, more abstract scenes using the same technique. I think this is really important because you get to know my way of thinking when making abstract art. And by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said and done, let's get straight into the video. For wet maps, you will always need a canvas, which is for me just going to be this plane, and a brush, I'm just going to pick this UV sphere. The brush will later be our simulation from Mantaflow, but for this part, I'm just going to use the sphere. Okay, now we're just going to go into the physics tab and enable dynamic paint, as well as choose brush as the type and add the brush. Now we can select the plane and add a canvas. Next, we will scroll down to output and click on this plus icon so we get both output layers as vertex colors. We can then use them later in the shading process. For now, I will leave everything as is and just move the sphere downwards so it collides with the plane. And next, I will go into the shader editor and give the plane a new shader. And then under input, vertex colors, we can choose wet map and the paint map. Okay, let's just go into the rendered view and see what these maps do. So, if you have the node wrangler add-on enabled, you can just hit Ctrl, Shift and click on the nodes. And you see that right now, they are doing nothing. This is because we want to subdivide the plane. So go into edit mode and hit subdivide. You can also do this with a modifier. So just move them above the dynamic paint and you can already start to see what it's doing. I'm just going to choose simple and then up the resolution, like this. Of course, for a better wet map, you will also need more subdivisions. So I'm just going to add another modifier like this and give the plane some more subdivisions. Because we can't really see the wet map, I'm going to select the brush and under paint source, I'm going to choose mesh volume plus proximity. Now it paints also outside the mesh, but the radius is a bit too high, so I'm just going to set the distance to 0.1, like this. And you can now see if I move the sphere, also the paint map moves. Now we want to decide on what to use, either paint map or the wet map. The paint map looks a bit different, it's more smoothed out, and that's why we're just going to use the wet map, because this just looks more natural for something like water. The next thing would be to again connect the principled BSDF and then plug the factor into the roughness. You can now see that there where there should be water, it's just rough and the other parts of the plane are really shiny. This gets more noticeable if I go into the material preview mode. I'm also gonna lower the color of the plane so we can see it more clearly. So we want to invert this. For this we can just use a color ramp and then flip the color ramp, and now everything near the sphere is wet. If you want to see more, we can of course select the brush and increase the distance, like this. For further refinement, we can also adjust the dry and dissolve option, but you probably just want the dry option when you want to have water on your object. Okay, but how do we get from this to simulations like this one? Let me just quickly load up a different scene and again add in a plane like this, and I'm just going to scale it up to 5. I'm just going to make a really quick demo. So I'm just going to add in the sphere and a curve, and to be precise a circle, and I'm going to move this one up, select the sphere, and we can actually clear out the position and then go into the object constraints and add a follow path and select the curve. Now we can animate the sphere on the curve. So on frame 1, I'm gonna give it a keyframe, and on frame 100, I'm gonna choose an offset of 100, which will move the sphere in a complete circle, and then give it another keyframe. We can also set the end of our entire simulation to frame 100, and now this looks like this. I personally don't want any acceleration, and so I'm just going to go into the graph editor, hit T, and choose linear. Okay, now our sphere moves along this Bezier curve, and now we want to add all the Manta flow parts. So select fluid, flow, liquid, and inflow, so it emits particles over time. I'm also going to choose initial velocity, so the particles move accordingly. The plane is going to be a effector collision, and we also want a cube which covers our entire simulation like this one, and choose domain and liquid. There is a small bug in the newest version because liquid is checked as standard, but it isn't actually checked. It is just a annoying bug, so we just have to click on it again, and now liquid is checked. The next thing would be to bake, but of course I'm just gonna save it first. Okay, for our simulation we don't want that many particles, so I'm gonna leave it at 64 and hit bake data. So you can now see that our sphere is emitting particles, only to frame 50, but this is okay for this tutorial because I forgot to set the start and end frame, but I'm just gonna use the simulation to frame 50. The next thing would be the wet map. So select your domain because the domain has all the particles. Select dynamic paint, brush, and add the brush. Then you can select particle system and choose the flip particles because we're gonna paint with them. For a real wet map, you would want to use the mesh, but because we want to go further into the abstract art, I'm just gonna use the particles and also choose a radius of 0.06, like this. Now we want to subdivide our plane, so add a subdivision surface modifier, and for the sake of this tutorial, I'm not gonna use this many subdivisions, only a few. Well, this is also not gonna look that great, but I think we can work with it. So also select dynamic paint, add the canvas, and now we can choose displace, for example. You can now start to see that the particles will displace our mesh. For a better displacement, I want to have some substeps, which is only gonna be relevant when you really have a high resolution mesh, and also choose incremental. You can also choose a negative displace factor, then the mesh will be displaced upwards, like this. And the incremental option lets the displacement stack on one another. So if I unenable it, you can see that we just get one plateau and not these high spikes. What I like to do next is choose image sequence and a according resolution. For me, this is just going to be 256. And right here, also choose displace. Now we can get an output folder and hit bake image sequence. We now get these images, which are essentially just the displacement map baked into images. We can now re-import them onto our plane. So just add a displace modifier, new, and choose image or movie, open, and then select your images. And now we can see that we get the displacement working. I think this looks really cool, and now we can also delete all the fluid settings and dynamic paints because we have it baked. So just delete everything you don't need, like this, and we have our displacement. If you see something like this happening, that we get displacement on the edge, this is either caused by a wrong bake, or if we go into the edit mode and scale up the plane, we can see that this actually gets tiled. We can fix that by going into the texture settings and under mapping, choose extend, and now we can see that, well, of course, this happens right now because it extends also the black parts on the side of our mesh. But if you have a big enough plane where all the outer parts will be the same color, extend works perfectly fine. What I also want to do is adjust the mid-level. For this, I'm gonna go into the orthographic view and move it up or down so it sits there where it was before, like this. And this is essentially how you can use wet maps to create some abstract art. For the shading, I used an ambient occlusion shader as the mix factor for the principal BSDF and an emission shader to get this nice shading. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you think so, then consider liking and subscribing, and we're gonna see us in the next video.